Alright, hello everybody, and welcome to another War Thunder video. This is going to be a bit of a sort of one of those videos where I kind of show what I'm talking about and then ask about it. I'm assuming that this is just a very unfortunate bug. I had no idea if it was intentional or not yesterday, but what I'm referring to, and I'm curious to know if any of you have experienced this problem as well, when the update went live and I played on release day, my squad mate and I experienced something, well, I experienced something, where an enemy had shot me and hit my ass, setting my fuel off. Or, excuse me, catching me on fire, right? They hit my fuel tank and caught me on fire. And I stop, put the fire out, use an extinguisher, he gets killed, and then the fire goes out, I start rolling forward again, and about 2 seconds after I put the fire out, just I catch on fire again. You know, I didn't get shot or anything. There's nothing. It just randomly sparks fly out of my engine compartment again. And so I'm stuck there and I can't use FPE again because some bright person over at Gaijin Entertainment decided it'd be a good idea to add a cooldown timer to FPE now. So I have to sit there and burn while waiting for my second FPE. And then finally, when I get my second FPE, I use it. It extinguishes the fire, but it doesn't extinguish the fire. So I sit there burning without FPE for the next 5-10 seconds, however long, until my tank explodes. It happened once. I saved the replay. Unfortunately, I don't have the replay anymore. And I was, you know, and it hasn't happened since. So I thought, okay, must have just been some sort of bug. It didn't happen until yesterday. It happened again, which is we're going to take a look at the replay so that I can show you what I'm talking about. A similar thing happened yesterday. And then I was like, okay, well, considering the rarity, it must definitely be a bug, or I would hope. Then we come to the very next day, and of course, I experience it again. So now it's starting to really get on my nerves because it's starting to happen a lot more often. And the one that happened today, which is the second replay I'll show you, is basically what confirmed to me that it's some sort of bug because of how broken it is when you see what I'm going to show you. But let's take a look at the first one. Now, we're doing this live, so we've got to go in. We'll take a look at the match from yesterday. I named it Fire, Fire, Fire on Maginot Line. And it's really annoying because not only does it result in most of the time, for example, in the second replay, it actually doesn't result in a death. It's an inconvenience. It could have resulted in a death. This time it results in a death, just like it did during the very first match, because there's nothing that I can do about it. And it's extremely annoying. I don't know what causes it. I don't know like what the trigger for it is. I'm not sure if the server hiccups when it happens or something. Regardless, it's not like the server rubber banded, you know, and I was rubber banding or something and I was unable to, you know, I used an FPE, but then it came back and I had to use it again. It wasn't one of those cases. So the enemy we're going to want to focus on here is this person right down here. He's in his Panzer III. When he jumps into his Panzer IIIM, because he's actually the person that sets my engine on fire. So let's go ahead and play it in top speed because we're going to be blasting through a little bit of this match here. Just a little bit of patience. Okay, so it's coming up here in just a little bit. So I'm sitting here, I'm next to this Chinu 2 driver, and there's that KV-1 over there, and that's kind of what we're worried about right now. My squad mate's down there, and you'll notice, now of course I didn't notice this is why I ended up getting shot, but just between these buildings here, that Panzer III driver is going to appear. And he's going to see me, but I'm not going to see him. In fact, there you can see him right there. Now, he doesn't have a line of fire right now. So I'm turning around and I'm coming back. However, I believe, right here. So he is actually back between those buildings. Of course, like I said, I can't see him in battle because not only is he not spotted at the moment, but I'm under the assumption that the buildings next to me are protecting me from flank fire. Unfortunately, for me, that wasn't the case. So he hits me in the ass, knocks out my engine. Okay, which also sets me on fire. I use FPE. He hits me again while FPE is going. Fire is put out. I wait. Thankfully, I get my movement back before he shoots me again. But then, just like I said, randomly, I'm on fire again for no reason. There is no warning. I didn't get hit again. I didn't, nothing. And my engine is like, nope, we're just going to catch on fire again after using FPE. So I pull forward, and this is unfortunate. I use my second FPE, but it doesn't matter. It kills me anyways. So that's the first instance of this happening that I managed to grab on video. Again, have no fucking clue what causes it. And this, I wouldn't have died here, most likely. Well, I could have. But if they didn't have this, whatever dumbass at Gaijin Entertainment, you know, and I'm going to use any insult I can that thought, I mean, what is the point in an FPE cooldown? What is the point in having it? I guess so that the game can bug out like this and get me killed? I guess that's why they added it? Because if there was no cooldown, I would have been able to use it again right when I caught on fire. But the reason I say that might not have saved me is because that exact same thing happened in the very first match of this update that I played, where that exact same thing happened. I caught on fire, put it out, caught on fire again randomly, put it out, and then caught on fire again right after that. So I ended up dying anyways. So, you know, like I said, for all I know, it probably wouldn't have worked anyways. Now let's take a look at the match that just happened. So this match I literally just played about 15 minutes ago. And it is not that one. Right here, Eastern Europe. And this is the one that I said pretty much confirms that it's some sort of bug problem. So we're going to go ahead and skip through most of the match again. This, I think. And this time the culprit's a bomb rather than an actual tank. So moving forward, I end up getting killed in my T-44. So it's actually my IS-2 that this happens to. Okay, so now we're in the IS-2. Now keep in mind that this is the IS-2 Revenge, which means it's a premium. So it comes with all the like all your parts and stuff like that, right? And that's it. I bring that up on purpose because of something. Just a moment. So we're over here now. We're waffling about. I keep pausing it because I think. Yeah, I killed that guy. I pulled back. Okay, here's I think where everything goes. Whoops, goes to shit. So I'm sitting here, and bombs are being dropped. So instinctively, I move forward. Now, unfortunately for me, the bombs landed in front of me, or on top of me. However, I'm still able to get away mostly intact. So the bomb goes off, and it blows off both of my tracks, and kills my engine and sets me on fire. Okay, so easy peasy, simple pimple, right? Now here's what happens. I put the fire out. And I'm sitting here. And I'm trying to repair. It won't repair. I'm spamming F. It's not repairing. And I'm like, what the fuck is going on? This is not a stock mod 1944. This has parts. I can't repair. It simply isn't letting me repair. So then, my cooldown's over for FPE. And as you can see, I'm just sitting here. Can't repair. Wondering, what the fuck is going on? This is arcade to begin with. So even if I didn't have parts, your tracks repair automatically in arcade. You know, I would be stuck with a shitty engine, but I'd still be able to move because it's arcade. So why can't I move? Why won't it let me repair? Well, as some of you know, when you're on fire, as the replay says over here, I am on fire. I just put the fire out. You don't even see a damn fire. How am I on fire? And then that's when the message flashes up on my screen. Your tank is on fire. Press F for FPE or whatever the fucking key is. So, of course, I put out a non-existent fire. Are you kidding me? 2 days in a row now, I've had this fucking fire issue. Now, I've used both of my FPE when I should have only had to use one. Thankfully, though, this time it doesn't get me killed like it did in the last match. But this one, it's a waste of both of my FPE, and I don't understand what causes it. Like, I have perfect ping in this match. I have no idea what causes this problem to happen. I don't understand whatsoever. And it was this match, like I said, that confirmed to me that this has got to be some sort of bug. Because a non-existent fire reappearing that you can't even see, and that, you know, So, in that case, I want to know if any of you guys have had this issue recently or not. And if you have, then we know that it's... if you haven't, then I may just be, you know, one of the very few cases where this is happening. If a few other people have had this issue, then obviously we know it's a little bit more widespread than not. But from everyone I've asked, personally, no one else I've asked has had... excuse me, I don't know what that freeze was. No one else has had this issue for them. So, I don't know. That's why I'm posting a video about it. So yeah, there's that. I was going to do a video yesterday. That's why I saved the fire. I was like, okay, I'll do this replay. I'll do a video on this replay in like a couple days. But since it happened again just now, I was like, you know what? Fuck it. We're doing a video right now so that I can show both of these matches and talk about the first time it happened. So now personally for me, it's happened three times with three completely different tanks in three completely different matches. Two times it got me killed. This time it actually didn't get me killed, but it could have if it didn't pop up on my screen telling me that my tank was on fire. I literally would not have known, because there's no indication that you're on fire. You know, there I wasn't getting any damage indicators. I couldn't visually see my tank on fire. I would have sat there until suddenly I would have just burst in, you know, exploded like you normally would when your ammunition or fuel or whatever gets set off from the fire. I don't know. So there's that, guys. That's going to bring this one to an end. I'm going to upload this, I think, probably right away or as soon as possible. I have another video that I want to upload War Thunder related. It's going to be a replay, another replay like this. What does the blue fire mean? Oh, fire extinguished. That's pretty, that's a cool color. Anyways, I have a replay that I want to do. So, but it's going to be a replay. It's an episode, a matches episode, but it's going to be a replay because I wasn't recording it live when it happened. In fact, I might actually record that right after this and upload it today at some point. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you in the next War Thunder video.